pre-tribulational promotional training modules. These training modules are best designed to help you teach and promote the pre-tribulational rapture. To better help you understand how the pre-tribulational rapture works, it is important for you to note that the words and sentences that appear in white represent things you should say or do, and the things that are in red are the things that you should avoid. Module 1. Conditioning the flock. Remember that 80% or more of your congregation will not even turn to or look up the verses that you're reading from the Bible. 99.9% will never even check the context of the scripture that you're reading from. And finally, if you repeat a statement enough times over a long period of time, it becomes a fact in the minds of the people that hear it. For example, most people think that Eve bit into an apple, that there are three wise men in the Bible, that somewhere in the Bible it says, God helps those who help themselves. Module 2. Emphasize imminence. The notion that Jesus could come at any moment, at any time, will instill a sense of urgency to join the church, to commit their time and services, and most importantly, to give of one's tithes and offerings. It is recommended to never mention or remind the congregation that Jesus said, "The end is not yet. These are the beginning of sorrows, and he that endures to the end." These statements could only serve to undermine the members that could speedily make reparations to our creed. Module 3. Enjoy popular recognition. It is a well-known fact that the pre-tribulational rapture is the most widely accepted doctrine in the world today. Embrace this reality for all its worth. Whenever possible, use elaborate charts and graphs when making the pre-tribulational scenario fit into the Bible. Also, interject positive emotional statements like, God would never beat up his bride. Wake up. Look up. We're going up. Module 4. Scripture presentation. Never get bogged down with detail, especially with Bible truth. For example, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, where Jesus returns first and then he raptures. Remember to maintain the rapture, 7 years of tribulation, and then another return policy. Also, maintain the Antichrist steps onto the scene after the rapture. Always refer to the falling away as not many people joining the church in the last days. Never use the original meaning from the Greek as the great apostasy of the last days. They might take that to mean as the popular doctrine in these days. Above all, never, I repeat, never read or say aloud the first part of Matthew chapter 24, verse 29. Always begin with verse 30. Your congregation could quite possibly confuse the words of Jesus as being chronological. Module 5. Interpreting Scripture. Remember that it's your opinion that counts. The more sincere, the better. When all else fails, remember to use the fallback verses of, "We are not appointed to wrath," and "keeping us from the hour of temptation." Give no heed to the thought that 11 of the 12 apostles were martyred, because we operate on a higher spiritual plane of knowledge, and we, in effect, are so much better than they ever were. Now, let's test your knowledge by answering a few multiple-choice questions. Question number 1. How many raptures are in the pre-tribulational doctrine? A. None. B. One half. C. One. Or D. Two. One before the tribulation and one after. In Matthew 24, when does Jesus say he will return? A. Immediately after the tribulation. B. The stars fall from heaven. C. Powers of the heavens are shaken. Or D. Matthew 24 is null and void because it's strictly to the Jews. Question number 3. In the silent rapture event, what is the correct order? A. The Lord himself descends with a shout. B. The voice of an archangel. C. The trump of God. D. Quietly, all Christians disappear while all others are left behind. Question number 4. When did the rapture become imminent? A. Cosmic events of Matthew 24. B. At the last trump. C. When Jesus sends forth his angels. D. Any day, any hour after Pentecost. And finally, how many first resurrections are before the first resurrection? A. The first resurrection happens when the dead in Christ are raised first. B, at the last trump. C, in Revelation 20, verses 4 through 5. Or D, there are three phases of a first resurrection in pre-tribulationalism. If you answer D for all questions, congratulations, you are certifiable, diehard pre-tribulational rapture expert. You will never have to worry about facing hard times such as what Jesus spoke of in Matthew 24. Things like famines, pestilences, and earthquakes. You don't have to think about being persecuted or killed. And if someone devises an economical device that allows you to purchase goods without cash, well, that's just another piece of technology you can use. After all, the rapture will come way before that happens. From the makers of the gender-neutral Bible comes the Convertible Bible. Tired of those post-tribbers getting the upper hand on scripture verses? Bothered by those pesky passages of enduring to the end? Well, now you can change all that. With our new point-and-click and replace tool, just grab, slide, and restore. You'll never have to worry about the tribulation anymore. But wait, there's more. Can't get around rock-solid words like after the tribulation? Just throw the whole word out with our not-so-patented Rip and Removal Cycle Eliminator. Just replace it with the more user-friendly before the tribulation. Call within the next 10 minutes and receive "This car could crash into you if I'm raptured" bumper sticker. Order yours today. Offer void with pathological verification prohibited. Not responsible for any godly copyrights that will be infringed. Module X, the final note. Take a look at this man. Study his face intently. We have slowed down the video and darkened the contrast to enhance his sinister look. It is highly recommended that you avoid him at all costs. He will take you to task on this issue. He will point out all the many flaws in the pre-tribulational doctrine while supporting his own agenda of enduring to the end. His post-tribulational views are in direct opposition to the early rapture and Christian prosperity movement. This man will spoil your sense of security of having you face or possibly go through the problems of this world.
Lord, give me a sign, for this is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and the righteousness is of me, said the Lord. Amen. Lord, give me a sign. I really need to talk to you, Lord. Since the last time we talked, the walk has been hard. Now I know you haven't left me, but I feel like I'm alone. I'm a big boy now, but I'm still not grown, and I'm still going through it. Pain and a hurt, soaking up trouble like rain in the dirt. And I know only I can stop the rain with just a mention of my Savior's name. In the name of Jesus, devil, I rebuke you for what I go through and trying to make me do what I used to. But all that stops right here. As long as the Lord's in my life, I will have no fear. I will know no pain from the light to the dark. Double show, no shame, spit it right from the heart. Cause it's right from the start. You held me down and nothing they can tell me now. Lord, give me a sign.
Let me know what's on your mind. Let me know what I'm gonna find. It's all in time. Show me how to teach the mind. Show me how to reach the blind.
Lord, give me a sign.
Show me what I got to do to bring me closer to you. Cause I'ma go through whatever you want me to. Just let me know what to do.
Lord, give me a sign.
Please show me something. I'm tired of talking to him, knowing he fretting. Crying about life ain't nothing. But you either be the one mad cause you trapped or the one hunting. Trapped in your own mind, waiting on the Lord. A hunting with the word that cuts like a sword. The spoken word is stronger than the strongest man. Carries the whole